This shit? You know, this is also a problem, because that's not really a problem, but you sent me a replay from like a month ago, which in a month you can improve a lot, but alright, we'll watch it. I also don't really like that it's a threes game. There's way more shit for you to learn in twos and ones, because it's you just have more chances to go for the ball and shit than in threes. Definitely don't flip towards the ball here, because if this guy would have hit the ball towards your net, you're flipping towards the ball, you're way too far pushed up, you can't reach that, so there's no point in trying to go for that. In the first 10 seconds, I can see you're one of the biggest monkeys I've ever seen in this game, probably. Which is unfortunate. Oh my god, dude, stop it! Stop diving so much, dude! You're done, stop it! I swear to god, you wanted to go for that. You probably go for this as well, okay. All I want you to be aware of here, like, okay, if you think you're fine with going for this risk, it's fine to go for this. It's really not, but if you really want to go for this, sure. But I just want you to be aware of the risk. Last man, yeah, sure, but it's not just last man. It's last man, but the fact is both of your teammates are kissing the fucking backboard. This ball is going to bounce, and this ball is really easy to blank the crossbar with. If you fucking rip this ball into the crossbar, it's going to bounce over your own fucking head. You outplay yourself. Basically, think of this as, think away everyone on the field except for you and the guy in net, the blue guy. It's basically one situation where this ball would bounce like this and you could shoot it. If you fuck up your shot, you're gonna get scored on. That's why playing once is so good for you, because these situations happen a lot, like everywhere, in every game mode. And in ones, you would probably like know to like try to take your time in some way so that you could fuck that guy in net without really getting countered, right? So it's a shit shot, at least you don't like hit it into the crossbar and get countered, but you could have just sat around here. Just let this ball bounce towards you, sit here, wait here. If someone pushes up towards you, try to get a touch over him. Try to get a touch that you can follow up though. So if you get a touch over the guy that challenges you and you can follow it up after that, you're doing amazing. Try to not just hit it instantly, you know. You shouldn't have taken that risk at all, especially not when you don't have to, you know. It's the first fucking 10 seconds of the game, you're not losing yet, and that could be the play where you either win, yeah, but that could also be the play that you because of that play, you lose, you know. And the worst part is that you didn't have to shoot, you had a lot of time here. So here, you're not really respecting this guy. Like, again, do you not realize that if you just sit here, if this guy hits it, he's gonna pass it to you. If this guy misses it, you can go now. But by going fast, there's, again, a lose-lose situation, which is, if you hit this ball before this guy does, so let's say you do hit it, right? You flip into the ball, you hit it, boom, bounces there, bounces here, give away possession to one of these two. So it doesn't really fucking matter if you hit the ball, and if you go fast, you use a lot of boost, ooh, you get beaten, ooh, you land here, you use all your boost, and you're out of position. So it's a lose-lose situation where even if you fucking hit that ball, it's give away possession anyway. This is Grand Champ, this is Champ 3, he said it is a low Grand Champ lobby. And that's probably why you send the replay. I like that you stay up though. The shot is trash, I'll just tell you that, because you think you're cool, and I want you to stop thinking you're cool, because you're not. It is, if you look at positioning and rotations, you know, that's a good choice to stay up there though. Alright, that's probably why you send it. It's really scuffed though. Like, I don't, like, if you wanna go for a flip reset, what I would do is I would fly towards the ball and I would flip, I would arrow like to the left so that, how do I explain that? That's so mechanical, like, it's hard to explain. You're fat, your mom, dude. I would fly towards the ball and then arrow to the left so that the right side of my car goes like that, and then the bottom of my car shows, instead of, you're kind of doing it the wrong, not the wrong way, because there is no wrong way, but it looks like really hard, if you get what I mean. Like, you make it really hard for yourself. That's fine. Well played, I guess. If you're comfortable with doing that, I can't really talk about it. Kind of love you though. I really don't love you. Fuck off, we're going for this. Even if you get this win, which you probably won't because you had momentum going backwards, even if you get this win though, you're gonna hit it. Wow, sicker, you're gonna hit it to that guy. Sick, give away a possession, you're gonna land in 3 minutes right around here with zero boost. You're gonna be out of the play for 85 years. So, and even if this guy beats you, it's the same shit here. It's literally good if he beats you because he's gonna pass it to that guy. That guy just has to be back and defend. So all I have to do here, if this ball goes over, is just rotate, grab boost that way or that way. That's all. Grab some fucking pads, homie. Don't sit under the ball. Oh, let me jump up for the ball. Let me hit it while you're all three there. Grand champ. This is what I fucking mean. If please, if you're stuck in plat, if you're stuck in diamond, if you're stuck in low champ, please, grand champ will not be better than your rank right now. It's I swear to God, it doesn't fucking get better. It gets worse because you think they'll be better. I'm at like 2K MMR. People still suck dick. It doesn't get better. Okay. Sick mechanics, brother, man. You scored a flip reset, right? No one fucking cares about that, cause you do shit like this, you know? First of all, you should have not missed every pad. You flipped in between these pads where you could have grabbed that one, maybe this one, or that one. Grab some pads here, first of all. So that you grab some pads. Second of all, you're a fucking last man. This guy net pushes out and you go behind him right around here. That's your position. With 24 boosts, with 30 boosts, how much you have, it doesn't really matter. And you fucking sit here. Wait here, because your objective as a, your goal as the last man, your job as the last man is to defend any shot on target if it gets past your teammates. Somehow. It doesn't matter how, but some fucking how, if it goes on target, you are there. That's your job. That's all. It's not fucking diving and triple committing with your teammates and then stealing their fucking boost here. You gotta fucking puke because of this shit. Yo, Pyro, thank you for the Twitch Prime sub, man. Appreciate it, dude. Weird ass flips here. No clue what this is. Yeah, flipping in between these two boosts. If you come like this and that boost is not there, you would prefer you're not even going for that boost if that shit is not there. If the boost is not there, like, you know, because you're all three there, it would probably just go back and grab pads. Then when you're here, I don't know if that boost is there. If it's there, you want to go for it. It's kind of risky because all three of you are pushed up again. Let's say this ball goes over him, which it happens, you know. Let's say this ball goes on target. This guy already turns towards the ball, and you're actually last man again here. So if you went for this boost and this ball went on target, that would have been a goal. So that's why I don't really like going for that boost. That's why I don't really like you going for this boost in the first place, because you were the last man in the first place, you know. So you gotta watch out with that. Probably grab some pads back without really being dumb. Really nice double jump here to aerial for the back boost. The problem here is, and it's not a problem, but I know it's gonna be a problem, is you were gonna hit this ball away, just like your teammate will here. How is that a problem? Well, let me explain. Let's think away your teammate. Let's say you were gonna hit this ball, right? You're gonna drive up. Let's see, you already jumped. Fucking hell, dude. So, you're gonna hit this ball. It's probably gonna land here. Boom, blap, bounce. You might double tap it, sure. So, bounce back to you. You hit it again. Sure. It doesn't matter. Double tap or not. What you're gonna do is you're gonna hit the ball into the wall and it's gonna bounce here, right? Over your head, probably. And you're gonna land here. You're gonna use a lot of boost. You're gonna land here. Ball's gonna bounce here. Look at this guy. Look at like any opponent. If that guy was positioned better instead of fucking under the ball here, he could probably shoot that as well. So that's what happens. Your teammate hits it. Your teammate actually, this is a decent hit because he could have probably followed up, but not really because, again, your opponent is there. So all you have to do here on the wall, instead of giving away possession, instead of hitting it, yeah, you're really fucking cool for hitting the ball. Yeah, you have mechanics. Wow, you just scored a flip reset 30 seconds ago. Really fucking cool. But it's these fucking little details that you need to fix to get better. Yeah, you're a grand champ, but you still fucking hit the ball here, which is give away possession. So all you have to do is drive up towards this ball, sit here in the position that the ball is going to land on the wall. You sit here, let the ball hit your car, and bam, that's your ball now. You drive off the wall with the ball, come down, and try to keep possession. If someone wants to challenge you, all you have to do is jump off the wall, pop it over him. Try to not, like, if you don't have to, try to not flip or anything. Try to get a touch over an opponent with while you can still, like, follow the ball up as well, you know. Is that, dude? I was almost happy that you were probably gonna hit this into the sidewall so that you could go again, right? It really looked like you were just gonna boom it here, and it would boom here, bam, bloop, and then you would land around here, boom, that's your ball. right? I was almost happy. That's also not the best thing though. Best thing would probably just hitting it up here through this mid boost, going to mid boost, going to wall. If no one goes, go off the wall and then go down. That would probably be the best thing. But this is fine, hitting it there, hitting it back to you, even though you won't get boost in that play. But it's fine since you at least have the ball. But nope, Grand Champ, let me hit the ball away, boys. Hey, like, come on, bruh. Now, you, like, all you do with this shit is, I'm actually trash. You're not. You just have to focus on this shit. It's really hard in game. You know, I hit the ball away as well a lot. No one can play perfect. We're just striving to minimize the mistakes you make. I don't judge you. I don't blame you. You don't have to say you're trash, my man. All I'm doing is pointing the shit out so you can learn from it. That's all, homie. So all you're doing here is giving the ball towards them. And then you're giving them the chance to create a play. The thing is, what's beautiful about this game, and this is why I've been hating this game for years, and this is why I want to retire, is that this guy instantly fucking booms the ball as well. And now that's giveaway of position as well back to you. So it's in a sense, it's good, but if everyone had a fucking brain, then the people that would take the ball the first time, like the people that would actually control the ball, they would be in a better position, you know? So now we go back to another guy who's now his ball. Let's take a look here. First of all, this guy had to rotate away instead of going like this. You need to rotate around so you can fuck off, and then it's this guy's ball, right? So then, let's see what they do. Oh, let me hit the ball away. Sick. Now let's take a look at this guy, yeah? Let's take a look. Oh, let me hit the ball away. Sick. Now let's take a look at this guy. Oh, let me try to hit the ball away and fucking miss, and even if you hit that ball, you weren't gonna give it away. Now let's just take a look at you. Let me fucking hit the ball away, and that's Grand Champ right there, my man. I'm fucking done, dude. This is what I mean. It doesn't fucking do anything. Let's take a look. You give it away. Let's take a look what these guys do. This is a man that tries to fucking take his time. He fucks up, though. But again, the play here is now they actually got the ball. Now gonna actually do something. Even if you hit that ball cool and shit, you know. But it's just garbage. Just to show real quick how much it happens, even in Grand Chip, you know. Let's go all the way back here to show your shit now. To watch your shit. First of all, all you have to do as a last man here is wait in net. You want to wait behind the line since it plays on the left side. You want to wait a bit more towards the right side. Why? Since if they somehow shoot it here, if you're here, you can't really backflip and save it because your backflip can't really reach that far. So if you sit here, you can backflip and save it there. And you can also save it here because you can boost and go for that shot as well. So you want to sit around here and wait here. There is no real reason for you to push out here, especially if your teammate is in the corner already. Yo, Cheerios, thank you for the Twitch Prime sub, my man. Appreciate it a lot, dude. Thank you so much, man. So you want to just wait here, sit here. Your teammate is in a fucking corner, man. He's doing the shit he needs to do. If he fucks up, then that's your ball. But if he's there, it's not your ball, you know. You just sit here and wait here. You don't want to double commit with your teammate or some shit. Flipping is committing, my man. They're like, what's the point of flipping when there's about, like, something is about to happen? Either that teammate of you is gonna 50 with that guy, and he's gonna fucking hit it over his head, or your team is gonna win it. But you don't want to commit at those moments where it's like the play is building up and something is gonna happen, and the ball's gonna go somewhere, but you don't know yet where it's gonna go. So you don't want to fucking flip already, so you commit into this position where like, you're fine now because the ball lands literally in front of them, so you're fine. But if this ball went anywhere around here, you can't go for it anymore, you know? You don't have to commit to anything. You know, you just sit here, you just drive up a bit. Yeah, it's cool and all, but don't fucking flip. Also, make sure you try to get a touch so you can follow up instead of just this, and now you're probably gonna turn under the ball. You're a Grand Champ if you do this. You're in the corner, fucking rotate away, dummy. This is your teammate's ball, please let him go. You can go for the back boost, though. I don't really like that, leaving the back boost thing here, unless your teammate grabs it. Okay, that's good. If your teammate doesn't grab it, though, then your opponents are gonna grab it, which is a problem. Let's see if you bumped your teammate here. That's amazing. Always, again, make sure you have that motion in here that you don't want to rotate straight like this. Oh, let me fucking bump you. You want to always go around. Have that half a circle motion in your shit and come here. Right? Pretty easy. Now, just don't fucking go straight, dude. No! Why not, you might ask? Well, two things. First of all, your whole fucking team is in that corner. That's like, that should be enough by itself. Only that. There's actually three things. Second is, you're not gonna score that.
You suck. Low grand champ, motherfucker. Yeah, you hit a flip. Okay, you might actually score that, right? The problem is that there is a low chance you're going to score it. You know, and if you don't score and you hit it backboard, for example, your whole team again is there in the corner. No one is going to do anything, right? so, you know, third, you're up 2-0. It's pretty aggressive. You know, 3 minutes left. All you have to do is defend. You'll win the whole game. I don't know if you're playing to win the game. You want to play it to rank up. If you're playing for fun, fuck it. Go for this. But I imagine you sending in the replay. You want to get better at the game. Then, you know, you don't want to fucking go for this because you're probably not going to score that. Your whole team is there and you're already winning. Yeah, this is what I mean. Sick read, bruv. And even if you read this again, so you're probably not going to do anything with it. And you jump from really far away. And your team is there. And you suck. And this and that. Just have some patience, my man. Don't be so desperate. Don't try to go for that. No. As you pushed up a bit too far here, in my opinion. Because this is a pass from this guy to this guy. And if this guy jumps and shoots this now, you need to be on your way back already. And you're kind of still facing the boost. It's a millisecond work. Yeah, you're facing towards the ball or towards the goal now. But you're still kind of pushed up too far. I'd rather have you in a position where you're already ready for that. Just for yourself. Oh, you're really far away. Let me go for this. Wow, sicko. Wow, I got beaten. Oh, how did that happen? Well, maybe because the guy that's there is literally under the fucking ball already. And he could fucking jump up now and he's beating you. You're like 85,000 kilometers away or miles. I don't fucking know for any NA weebs in this chat. It doesn't fucking matter. You're really far away. Fuck it. You're not gonna do anything. So you don't want to get beaten for that. Because, you know, you can let him go up. You can drive up to him, make him do something, which is good. Because then he'd jump up for the arrow, he'd use boost, and he would fucking give the ball to your teammates, right? But don't jump up and use 85 million boost and outplay yourself. Let him... what the fuck is that? Let him outplay himself, you know, but don't outplay yourself. Useless touches. This touch is actually fine. I don't want to say I like it, but I kind of do, because you land here, and let's say you actually got a touch here towards the side wall, corner wall. This would be a decent pass, I imagine. So that's fine. The problem here is, though, you land, he hits it towards you, you have a lot of time. This guy's not going again yet. He wants to go again, but he's not going yet. So there's no real point for you to try and hit this ball instantly, because wow, you hit it, wow, sick, now they're going to take. Yo, let me try and hit it again. Hey, you're fucking yourself up. You're trapping yourself into playing faster. You're trapping yourself into giving away ball possession here. Whereas you could have sat on the wall here. Maybe got a touch that you control the ball with. Maybe come down the wall and just sit here. Because that guy is there, you know. He's not close to the ball yet. So you could probably just wait under the ball, let this ball bounce like that, and just sit here. And then when this guy challenges you, you can maybe fake him where you go towards the ball and then you don't hit it. And he might like pre-jump a hit. They might fake him, or you could come under ball, let the ball hit your car, then just jump up once. You don't really want to flip if you don't have to, you know. You try to get past the first guy without committing to something. So if you jump up and it goes over him, you can land there, you can go again. That's the beauty of it. Or you can come on the wall here, let this ball be in a position where the ball is going to bounce on the wall. You sit here, let the ball bounce in your car, and then just keep driving. And then you can at least try to do something. That's also forcing yourself to play faster, because then you're on the corner wall, and then this guy's going to challenge. But that's at least better than just hitting it like that, you know. Try, like, actually have something, like, create a play that you can do something with, you know. That's good. You go your way back. Don't tell me, dude. Grand champ, man. You're 60 boost wasted into a ball that you can't even reach. And even if you were gonna reach, boom, hit it there, boom, hit it there. Oh, yeah, maybe this guy was gonna hit it, but you're up 2-0, and you're not even gonna reach. And this guy, come on, man. Your rotations are kind of whack, dude. I don't know. I would not rotate all the way through there if I could just rotate like this, to be fair. Because you're also rotating towards the ball. The whole play is going to be there. Your team is going to be there. I don't know. I'd probably just rotate like this, grab boost here. Grab pads or some shit if the big boosts are not there. This is good pads grabbing. No, don't tell me you're gonna fucking go for that. Dude, it's like you're playing threes, but you're playing You're playing, like, it's like you go to options, you go to video, and there's like advanced settings here, and there's like high quality, I mean, this shit, and there's like another option for you, it's cars, and you just turn it off. You don't see any fucking cars on the field. You're like, you just see the ball, it's gonna bounce, let me jump up for that. Like, that's how you fucking play this shit. There's 85,000 cars there, and they're gonna fucking hit the ball, and you jump from this far away. If they only hit it, if they only get a slight touch in it, you're fucked, you know? Like, what the fuck is that? You're the last man as well. Sick! Really nice! Watch him score now. Yeah, he scored. He definitely scored. You know, some homie sub to me.
Love these analysis sessions.
Sessions. That sounds so cringe. But Talk Smokes, hey, you're giving me money, so I gotta be nice to you, right? I love you! Hey, thank you for the Twitch Prime sub, man, for 2 months. Appreciate it, dude. That was a high-key quality rose. It was pretty funny, actually. That's a decent touch. Why? Because you can follow it, right? You gotta notice if there's someone on the backboard or not, because you could actually see in that, like, little-ass moment there that there was no one there, and that you would then, it just give yourself that feeling that you have time, which is more comfortable, you know? There is someone right there now, but you just went faster than you had to, you know? You had to go a little bit faster, didn't have to go this fast. Okay, let's see if you get a good shot on target, top corner, yeah, you might score. Thing is, you're up 2-0. And this is a hard shot, and you suck, and there's a teammate in the corner already, and you don't want to fucking rely on your last man, because that's a fucking solo queue teammate, probably. Yes, it is. So let's take a look. Ooh! Ooh! Who would have thought? Hey! The Grand Champ, by the way, you know, like... I don't want to talk about it. Like, you could also just get into a position where this ball is gonna be, like, you can just sit here, wait here. This hasn't challenged you, you gotta be aware of it. So let this ball come towards you. When this ball comes towards you, like here, this guy would challenge you, right? Which means he would probably be here. All you have to do is drive towards this ball, hit it into the side wall, like, right around here. Don't want to hit it forward, because the more you hit it forward, the more you hit it towards your opponent, the more, like, you give him the chance to hit the ball. All you have to do is drive, hit this ball towards the side wall, hit it here, bloop, blap, it's gonna bounce out. This guy's gonna challenge you, and he's not gonna hit the ball, because again, you hit it to the side, instead of, because he's gonna just dive like this. And if you hit it all the way over there, he's never gonna hit that ball, right? So that's all you have to do. So you hit it there, and again, that's the beauty of it, is that you're gonna outplay him without, like, taking yourself out of the game. So you're gonna hit the ball there, it's gonna bounce out, you're gonna sit here, the ball's gonna bounce back to you, and now it's only this guy left, because this guy's getting fucking harassed in the corner. Whereas if you shot that shit, there is a guy in net that could probably save it. Again, if you get a top corner shot, it'd probably be in, but now your team is going to get 2v1'd. And yeah, you get kind of lucky that he did. Oh, let me jump from 8,000 kilometers away again. Oh, what a hit, dude. Hey, good job, man. 80 boozy. Let me try again. That's actually a decent hit. Like, that's fine. But the problem is, you know, the first hit, like, what's the point of this? Mods are in Crusade versus Copypastas. Do you approve? What do my mods suck dick? First is questionable. First is definitely not even questionable. It's just shit. Because, yeah, you get the touch and it's kind of garbo. Someone should have been on the wall here to actually take this ball already. And then you're outplaying yourself. You use 80 boost, you land in the corner. And there should have been a blue guy here on the corner. Like here. And then he could take this ball and he could outplay this guy. Because this guy's also up. All this guy on the wall had to do is just hit it and then it'd be a 3v1. The second hit, I kind of like it because I would never expect my teammate to instantly be up for that. Why? Because he's not going to score that. It's the same shit with every shot you go for. It's useless. But you still get to 3v1 that guy. Don't fucking... Come on, man. Come on, man. That's a decent rotation. You sit here, you're like, oh, he's shooting. Oh, it's not really a good shot. My teammate is there. He's going to save it, right? What you can do if you don't really trust your teammates, which is what I would do, is I'd push up a bit. Because this shot is not that fast, you know? If it's a fucking good shot, I would jump for this every time. Even when I'm on complexity, if this is a fucking good shot and I'm here and this guy's here, I would jump for this because he might not save it, you know? But if this is a shot like this, all you have to do is sit here and have a little bit of momentum, so if this guy misses it, you can still save it, but you don't have to fucking instantly jump and, like, commit for this, you know? Because now you're gonna land here, wow. Sicko. And now since you landed there, you have a feeling that's your ball and shit. You double commit again, which is really nice. You can't even reach that ball. We still try to go for it, which is kind of garbo. Yeah, nice try. The problem is that you try to shoot this on target. Whereas this line of approach is amazing, in my opinion. Because what you're going to do here, if you hit this ball, is if you don't hit it into your teammate, of course, it's going to hit this right around here. Hit this ball like that, and it's going to bounce back to you. And that looked really amazing until you were like, oh, I have to try and hit this on target, and you fucking miss the ball. But let's say you don't miss the ball. Let's say also these guys are not there. Let's say you hit this ball on target. Boom. Oh, nice shot on target. This guy's going to save it. So it doesn't really matter, you know. Shots on target are trash if it's a bad shot. You were just gonna get a fucking shit shot on target, so what's the point of that? It's giveaway of possession. Really disrespecting everything here. What I mean by that is this guy, the blue guy on the wall, is getting a touch like that. This is a pass middle. This guy is gonna shoot now if he had a brain and he would hit this ball. And look at you. Last man already in this position, whereas he would hit the ball now and that ball would go on target. So again, let's take a look at it from a different POV to maybe show you how much of a risk this was. This guy gets a pass like this, and if he actually went for the pass, he would shoot it right about now, and look at where you are, and your net is completely open. Wait, why am I watching him still? You're the biggest fucking monkey I've ever seen. Like, it's unbelievable. It's actually unbelievable. Let me grab the mid boost. Let me rotate. I grab the mid boost, right? Let me instantly turn. Let me use 85 million boosts. Let me fucking challenge this, even though if this guy hits it, not like the only reason why you hit it is because this guy sucks, right? If this guy hits it here, softly, he just hits it here, right? You're gonna die for this, you're gonna be out of position, this guy's gonna just take the ball and he's gonna control you, you're gonna land it right around here. Okay, that's the first thing. Second thing is, even if you hit this fucking ball, which you do, and it's really cool, but take a look at this. What is that gonna do? I mean, you might fucking get this middle, you might score, but no. Because there's defenders, and it doesn't really matter, and there was such a big chance of you getting outplayed here. That is really not worth it. And it's, like, again, if you're 2-0 up, you don't have to do this. If you're losing by 10 seconds, with 10 seconds left, and you're losing by one goal, I could kind of see this being justified, because you could dive in, you can maybe get a good fucking read on them, get a good dunk, you can maybe score for him. But when you're 2-0 up, with 1 minute left, all you need to do is defend, and you'll win the game. You don't have to fucking grab the boost, turn around, challenge for this instantly, with a big chance of getting outplayed, and even if you get the dunk, you know, you might not really do anything with it. You're really playing as if you're always losing with 10 seconds left, one goal. That turn is fine. I don't mind it, because it's a soft touch from your teammate, but your teammate gives it away, so he can't really follow it, so I don't mind turning and diving for that. It's not really diving, because you can actually hit the ball, you know. Okay, so here, you realize that you have to PC, you realize it's a bit too late, because you kill your momentum, you watch that guy go for the ball, and then you go for a boost, which is good. You should have noticed it a little bit earlier, though. You have such fucking weird flips. Stop flipping left, right, left here. Hey, right again. Fucking just flip where you want to go instead of flipping like a weirdo. Flip forward here. Flip forward again. You don't have to fucking flip left, right, and shit, dude. Pass middle. Fucking, how is that open? Okay, all I'm saying is if these people had a fucking brain, this guy is the last man. He would never trust his teammate to hit the ball, because if he doesn't hit the ball, you're the last man, and you're the only goal you have. Is this really champ? This is grand champ, motherfucker. This shit sucks. This game sucks. Trust me. There's 1900 MMR, 2000 MMR, which is top 100. People suck, dude. So like, this guy, if this guy had a brain, he would never really rely on him hitting the ball. He would be back, and that's why I said pass middle, because this should have never been a goal. This guy should have been back around here, and then you would hit in. This is a shit shot. Then it would be a free save. That's why passing in middle, if this guy is back here, would be the best play. Or taking your time, one of the two. God fucking damn it, I'm hungry as shit, man. Feel for the man in this replay. I mean, you should not feel for him. You should actually be happy for him, because he's gonna be learning. Because this is
a personal fucking replay that is like it applies to him. He has made these mistakes, so it's actually pretty good that he's able to learn from this, right? Again, you fly from 85,000 kilometers away, 6 shot on target, 100 boost wasted for no fucking reason. Yeah, I don't know, you can just drive up to the ball and then you'll probably notice that no one is going up yet. And then you can just fucking go for the ball on the ground. You can just sit here. This ball would bounce back to the ground or it would come down. I have the fucking hiccups, man. So this ball would come down to the ground, you'd hit it like this or like that, doesn't really matter. All you have to do is come to one side, you watch, you wait.
Have a nice day, mate.
Yo, Pulsar, thank you for the Twitch Prime sub, man, for 2 months. Thank you for the kind words as well. Hope you have a wonderful day as well, man. So I have to do... If you wait for the ball to fall down, you waste time. You waste time for what? I'm done. First of all, wasting time would be good in this situation because there's 40 seconds left, you're winning. 3-0. Second of all, you're not wasting time. I mean, you are, but what's the problem of that? You can let the ball come down. So you're saying hitting this ball towards your opponent and giving them a chance to fucking counter you is better?
Sup, boys?
I have no clue. Yo, Clarsh, thank you for the Twitch Prime sub, man, for 2 months as well. Appreciate it, dude. So you can just wait down on the ground here, let this ball come down. If you see someone going for it, try to get a touch over that guy without really hitting it forward too much, so you could hit it, follow it up again, right? If no one is going for this, all you have to do is come down here, get a hit like this or get a hit like that, and then just come to the right side of the ball or to the left side of the ball. Wait for an opponent to challenge, don't just play towards them. You wait until the guy challenges, you power slide, cut it to the other side, and that's, you get it past one, and you can see what you can do from there on, right? What's up, Naughty? Wait. What just happened? Yari with a gifted sub to Toasty. Appreciate you, homie. Alright, let's see. You kind of have to watch out here with these turns. Alright, that's what I mean. So, you gotta know when you're in the corner like this and you rotate like this, you're a last man, right? The second you try to go infield here, you have to be aware of cutting rotation. Not from this guy, because this guy's fucked up. He's already first, man. He's already gone, kind of. You have to be aware of fucking up this guy's rotation, because this guy's the second man. This guy goes, he's the first man, he plays, he lands here. This guy then goes middle and pushes up, right? And now this guy, which is you, should go back. If you're a grand champ, right? Omegalo. Look at this. I'm a grand champ, mom. Look at this. You know, you think you're good. You're probably one of the worst grand champs I've seen. I don't want to talk shit about you, but I just hope that makes you think in a different way, you know? I just hope, like, I really don't care if you're really not good at the game or some shit. All I want you to do is realize it and try to learn from it, alright, homie? I'm sorry, but it's facts. Like, what I mean is, you have probably talked trash to so many of your fucking teammates. You've probably said so many times to your teammates, stop, like, fucking start rotating, stop fucking doing this, and now you actually make a lot of fucking mistakes, which is good for a replay, because I could teach you from it, but it's, how did you get grand champ, you know? It's mechanics, I know it is, but it's sad. But shout out to you, Pepsi, for sending in this replay, man. I just started playing last December. That's pretty impressive. Nice turn towards their goal when they're literally about to shoot. Really amazing. Like, do you not realize you flip this ball, it's good. Do you not realize that this guy's the last man? This guy's also the last man. This guy's already pushing up towards, but this guy's going towards his net. So in this position, you should have already made the decision to help your teammate out and go back to net. But nope. You don't really care about it. Yeah, I don't know. Here, you should notice that guy was flipping away from the boost here. So he's probably gone, which is facts. And then these two guys, this is all you can see. So then you should know that you have a lot of time here. And you shouldn't flip this ball away. You shouldn't fucking own goal here either. Shouldn't fucking triple commit with everyone. Yeah, it's kind of hitting the ball too far forward, but it's fine. Thank you for sending in the replay, Pepsi. Hope that helped, man.
Again, not mad at you, just being honest so that you can learn from it, alright, homie? Hope you appreciate it. Thank you, man. And anyone in chat talking trash to this guy, you guys are all fucking trash as well, so don't talk trash.